I've built a PS action for Inception Pictures that loads the images on layers. I've built one for 9 pictures and one for 11 pictures. The action helps to prepare the pictures to stretch them easier. There are some important rules for this PS action. The first is that we can only use 9 or 11 pictures. And then the second, rename all the pictures. The picture name will be the layer name, so that's important, that's always the same layer name. Do not change the origin resolution of the DJI pictures of 72 dots per inch. If you have prepared that, we can start the action. First we will load the pictures onto layers. Here we have the 9 picture action, and then the action will prepare all the pictures and will space up the work room. That's the reason we have always to use the same resolution of 72 dpi's. You can see the masks are blurred, only the first image is cut sharp. Then the masks are independent from the picture, so we can move them separately. At the first picture you can see I'm on the way, so we have cut off my figure on the second picture. Now you can see how we can move the picture, but we can also move independently the mask. That's very helpful for the manual stitching before we stretch the images. On the first image we use only the bottom part. There's a mask still there, but that's important that we reduce the layer on this mask. If you will stretch on the whole picture, you will not have the right curve. You can see it here, it's too big the size. So we have first to cut off on the mask size the picture. Now we have done it, and if we stretch it now, you will have much more curved shapes. That's very important that you cut off all the images. I blow up the whole picture size on 120% of the origin image, so we can use all the space to stretch the first image, or even more than the. Now we prepare the second layer, 50 degree picture. We can move the picture and the layer. I blurred the overlapping about 50 pixels. That's much more comfortable to stitch it manually. And it's also easy, you can see, to move the mask and move the images independently. Now reduce the layer on the mask size. That's important for stretching. And we stretch the second layer. We can always switch between stretch and rectangular mode, so we can adjust the size of the image. You can work in transparent mode to see the overlapping between the images, but also without transparent mode. For the other layers we will not use this function. I speed up the rest of the stitching, it's always the same. We place and stretch the images. I use a lot of layers for this image just to show how you can do it. Normally I use only 3 to 4 images for a whole Inception picture. Now at the end we fuse all the layers and we correct the overlapping with a stamping tool. For the next flatland image I use Daryl's images. PS action load all the pictures. He has a made a small radius. So at the end I used only 3 pictures for this flatland image. So we have prepared all the layers. And also here I stretched the first image on the whole size on 120%. You can even stretch more than the background image size. For this flatland image it was useful to do so. And at the end for the demonstration I used only 2 pictures for this flatland image. Now we put on the second layer. I used not a nadir picture. The nadir picture was too close for the whole picture size. You can see we have exposure difference between the first and the second picture, but we can correct that in Photoshop. It's easy to do. Then we have to adjust the final picture size. And it's nearly finished. For the next one, I used the drone blocks mission with a 5 and 10 degree angle. So it's quite a lot of pictures. And it's only to show that the PS Action does quite a lot of work of preparing of the whole image. You can download the PS Action on my homepage. I hope you enjoyed this episode and please let me know how it works.